Welcome to another Stories from the Stores. I'm here with curator Katie Dabin, and today we've got a Dewar flask.
So this is a Dewar flask for storing heads or brains in liquid nitrogen for cryogenic neuro-suspension.
Is there a head in there?
Thankfully, there isn't, because that would cause all sorts of headaches.
Okay, but that sounds super sci-fi, super like Futurama.
It sounds like a mad idea, but the reality is in medicine, we use freezing all the time for cells and tissues. So think about IVF, we store embryos and sperm and cells, so it's real science.
How does it actually work?
What you need to do is preserve the brain and the head. So you need to rapidly cool it to stop any cellular activity or any decay happening. So you've got to take it down in 3 hours to stop any ice crystals forming. And then there's a longer 2-week process of taking it down to minus 196 Celsius. And then these body parts are preserved for the future until they could be brought back to life.
I'm pretty sure people like Walt Disney, like some famous people, have had this, right?
Walt Disney was rumoured to be frozen, but he never was. He was actually buried. And in reality, there's only been about 150 people who've been frozen by the Alcor Life Extension Company, where this object comes from, and 33 pets. The first person to be frozen was Dr. James Bedard, and he was frozen in 1967. He was an American professor of psychology at the University of California.
Is this an unusual object for the museum to be collecting?
I think it's a really important object for the museum to collect. First of all, it represents how a small group of scientists and members of society are responding to one of, you know, mankind's biggest challenges, how to overcome death. But, you know, really interesting ethical issues about how we think about the future. So, you know, are you if your brain was put into a different body? How long should somebody live for? You know, what rights would you have if you were living in the future, if you were revived?
So you're a curator. Would you want to be preserved like this?
I think even if medical science catches up and you could live with all your personality and memories, I just think ultimately living in the future would be quite a lonely place. Would your friends and family be there? And I just think, you know, really you'd be a dinosaur living outside your own time.
You've got to understand that you haven't dissuaded me at all. I should live forever.
You should go for it.